Russell and Sister Annie. We are delighted to have you here in the sanctuary and online. It is a good thing to come into the house of the Lord, to sing His praises and to just bask in His presence. Amen. And we at Faith Center, we have had what a wonderful weekend. Amen. Hallelujah. So we are so grateful to have you here with us this evening. We have a lot to give God thanks for. Amen. Amen. We are grateful people. We are the redeemed of the Lord, and we say so. Amen. Hallelujah. This evening, let me invite you to stand as we give God honor and glory and praise unto His matchless name. We have come into His house to worship Him. We are the recipients of many breakthroughs. Hallelujah. Anybody here recipient of many breakthroughs? Amen. Amen. We have a lot to give God thanks and praise for. There's nothing special you did to cover yourself to come here this evening. Amen. But the Lord God Almighty protected you to be here in the land of the living. So the breath in your lungs, it's to worship Him. We were made for His honor and His glory. So this evening, remember that breakthrough that your God, whom you serve this day, brought you out of that miry clay, and He set you on your feet on solid rock to stay. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, we give you praise this evening. Lord, we give you praise and we give you thanks this evening, God. Lord, we are grateful people this evening, God. You have kept us, Lord, from the snare of the fowler. Lord, we thank you for your people here in the sanctuary and those online. Lord, may they experience the manifestation of your power. Lord, I pray today as they would worship you and praise you. Oh God, they will not worry and they will not fret, but they would look to the God who is great and mighty, our deliverer, our strong tower. The righteous will run in and be safe. So Lord, we thank you this evening. We lift hands before you this evening, God. Lord, and we say thank you, Jesus. Lord, sometimes all we can say is thank you, Jesus. You've been a good God. You've been a faithful God. Great and mighty is our God. He's the ruler of everything. We don't have to wait for a song to give Him thanks. We don't have to wait for the music to start. We can open our mouth because He inhabits the praises of His people. We the earth, we are the earth. We are the ones who He looks forward to hear the praises from. So lift up your voices and give Him thanks and give Him praise. You know the troubles and the trials that you have had, and He brought you out of it in the name of Jesus. His word says that this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice. We will rejoice. We will rejoice and be glad in it. It's not because of this and because of that, but because of who He is, we are able to give Him our best praise this evening. So Father, we thank you. Come on, saints, thank the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise. We give you praise. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice. No matter what you're going through this evening, He said to rejoice and be glad in it. Through your trials, through your tribulations, He's never going to leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. And this is the day that the Lord has made. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. We will rejoice. that's the blessed assurance we have. The righteous can run in, call upon his name, and be saved. Amen. Hallelujah. Ah, Jesus, you are help this evening. You are hope this evening. And I will lift up mine eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said, he will not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord which keepeth thee, and he will not slumber nor sleep.
The Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy
Jehovah Jireh this evening. Jehovah is his name. And this evening you might be trusting Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Shammah. He's mighty this evening. Hallelujah. Jehovah is your name. Call his name, Jehovah. Thank you. long we can. And yet you are here viewing, and yet you are in the sanctuary. So you have an expectation, a great expectation, that your God will manifest himself in every situation of your life. He's going to manifest himself because he's God. His integrity is like no other. He's a God of yea and amen. And many of you are bursting to give us testimonies of God's goodness. Many of you are bursting with excitement to tell us of the goodness of God in the land of the living. You have a new promotion to tell us about. You have a new job to tell us about. You have a new marriage. You want to tell us of the goodness of God in the marriage when so many marriages are failing. This evening, I just want you to cry out to God, to just seek his face, to call upon his name, to worship him this evening. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
speaking to us, his children, the saved, the redeemed. This was not a word for strangers. And he said, if my people will only humble themselves, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, God is saying that to his people. Now understand that it's not an accusation, it's not judgment today. But I believe that God responds to humility. His word also says, the prayer of a righteous man availeth much. So he responds to our righteousness this evening. So before we come down to the altar, we want to pray a prayer of repentance. You see, sometimes we don't know what is inside of us. We all have sinned and fallen short of that glory. So probably sometimes, you know, we're praying. So peradventure, there should be something in us. We might be unawares of such. We will all know what our struggles are. So tonight, before we come and present ourselves at the altar, Brother Benji is coming to lead us in a prayer of repentance.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You may have your seats. Thank you, Jesus. I just want to share a scripture from Luke chapter 17, verse 3 and verse 4. And it says, take heed to yourselves. If thy brother trespass against thee, rebuke him, and if he repent, forgive him. And if he trespass against thee 7 times in a day, and 7 times in a day, turn again to thee, saying, I repent, thou shalt forgive him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This evening I have been asked to pray a prayer of repentance. And Sister Karen just strengthened this by quoting, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and on Saturday night Brother Peter mentioned that when we pray, there are benefits that we receive from prayer. Sometimes we may feel as though we are praying, and nothing happened. But he said to keep praying, and we will receive the benefits. And it's true, because I experienced it many times. On Saturday night, when he said there are 17 benefits that he mentioned, I took note of everyone. And those benefits that he mentioned give me the encouragement to pray more every day. So this evening I want to pray a prayer of repentance. Father God, we come before your throne in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, O God. Father, to seek your face. Come in your house and seek your face. Father God, on this evening, I pray, O God, for repentance tonight. Father, you said in your word that if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek thy face, Father, you will hear from heaven and turn from their wicked ways. You will hear from heaven and you will forgive their sins and you will heal the land. So, Father, we take you at your word this evening, O God. Father, and we ask you, Lord, Father, to forgive us, O God, for every sin that we have committed, O God. We repent, O God, before you this evening, O God. Father, and we ask you, Lord, Father, to take our sins away, Lord. Every one of them, Lord, Father. Father, maybe we have sin in our thoughts. We have sin in our minds. We have sin in our hearts. Father, we ask you, Lord, to take it away. We repent of them all this evening, Father. We repent, O God, Father, O God, for not speaking to our neighbors. We repent, O God, Father, for not speaking, O God, Father, to our wives and our husbands, O God, to our children, O God. We repent, O God. Father, O God, this evening, O God, we ask you, Lord, Father, to search us. Search us, O God, where we have failed, O God, in these areas, Lord. Father, O God, we ask you, O God, to forgive us, O God. Father, we come humbly before you, O God, Father. And we ask you, Lord, Father, to take those sin away from us, O God. Father, O God, we are not too big, O God, Father, to say sorry. We are not too big, O God, Father, to ask you, O God, to forgive us, O God. Father, this evening, O God, we turn, O God, Father. We pray, O God, for repentance, O God, Father, for not, O speaking, O God, to the people, O God, on our jobs, O God. Father, O God, we repent, O God, for not speaking, O God, to the people that we pass on the streets, O God. Father, O God, we repent, O God, Father, for not spreading your word, O God, Father, speaking, O God, Father, to our loved ones, O God, Father. Father, we repent, O God, for not introducing Jesus, O God, to our family, O members, O God. Father, O God, we ask you, Lord, to forgive us, O God, Father. Father, O God, Father, we take for the things, O God, that seemed impossible, are possible with you, O God, Father. Father, O God, and we take you at your word this evening, O God. Father, this evening we are not too big to say sorry, O God. Father, O God, we come humble, we humble ourselves before you this evening. Father, and we say sorry, O God, Father, for failing, O God, to act, O God, Father, in the area, O God, where you call us to act, O God. And we thank you, O God, this evening for calling us, O God, from darkness, O God, and placing us into your marvelous light. Father, O God, and we thank you, O God, for granting us the opportunity, O God. Father, O God, to learn from you, O God. Father, to serve you, O God, Father. And because of this, O God, we are grateful to you, O God. Father, help us, O God, Father, to have a repentant heart, O God, Father. Father, O God, we ask you, O God, Father, O God, we stand in the gap, O God, Father, for your people this evening. We stand in the gap, O God, Father, for the people, O God, Father, that are lost this evening, O God. Father, O God, give us, O God, the boldness, O God, to reach out to them, Lord, Father. Father, help us, O God, Father, to lay aside every weight and every sin that easily beset us tonight, O God. Father, O God, and place us, O God, give us the boldness, O God, to reach out to those, to the people, O God. Reach out to souls this evening, O God. Take away fear. Take away doubts, O God. Father, O God, we thank you, O God, for your forgiveness this evening. Father, O God, we thank you, O God, as we call out, cry out unto you. You fill us, O God, with your Holy Spirit. You fill us, O God, with the right spirit, O God. Father, help us, O God, to walk in your obedience. Father, we thank you, O God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
righteousness and love, peace and forgiveness. And we want to enjoy that with you, Father God. We want to spend eternity with you, Father God. Lord, we thank you for all that you have done for us. You're a good God. Righteousness will make us whole, Lord. Let us not go after the things of the world, Father God. Let us put your kingdom and your righteousness first. And all the worldly things are going to be added for us, oh God. Oh God, the things of the world are just fringe benefits, Father God. But we are seeking eternal life. We want to live in eternity with you, Father God. So God, I pray, oh God, that you're going to strengthen our hearts. That we're going to know and we're going to understand what takes precedence in our life, Father God. It's putting you first. We're going to follow you, Lord, because we believe, because we love you, because you are righteous, Father God. Lord, Brother Angus taught us Saturday, there were three groups of people that followed Jesus. The first group was the scribes and the Pharisees, and they just looked for ways in which they could have trapped Jesus. And when you fast forward, Lord, there are people just like that today, Lord, who doubt the word of God, who do not believe. They are doubters, oh Father. And there are a second group who just followed for the bread and the fish. And those are the people who just wanted what they could have gotten. They were not taking in the word of God. They were not interested in the word of God, but what they can get for themselves, what they could benefit for themselves. Jesus. But there was a third group who believed that Jesus Christ was the Son of God, who believed that he died, and who believed that he was a righteous man. And they followed him not to get something, oh God, but what they could have given. And help us, we can be in that group, Lord, who are following because we can give something, oh God. We can come and we can serve you. We can talk to people about you. We can give of our time, of our talent, of our treasure. Lord, you are going to give us the benefit, Father God. And help us to be that kind of people, Lord, in that group, Lord, who come to church and come where we can give something unto you. Give our praise, give our honor. Thank you for all that you have done for us. Lord, we praise your name, Lord. And I pray that each of us is in that group tonight. The group who are willing to serve. The group who are willing to make sacrifices. The group who are willing to go out there and speak about you on their job. Wherever they are, our light will shine, Father God. Continue to strengthen us, Lord. Strengthen us that we can be that kind of people for you, oh God. That kind of people who are going to serve you. That kind of people who are going to make you proud of us, Lord. Oh God, we're going to put you first in all things. We're going to put you first. Because we know that the things of the world belongs to you. And if you are our Father and you own everything, we as your children, we are going to benefit, Lord. So we do not have to worry. All we got to do is serve you. God, praise your name. We cry out to you tonight, oh Father God, to make us better people. Where we are falling short, oh God, you strengthen us, oh God. Wherever we need fixing, Lord, you fix, Lord. We are imperfect, Lord, and we come before you. And we know that we are imperfect, but we ask you, Lord, to touch us, Lord. Because we are trying and we are giving you our best. We know that our righteousness is like filthy rags, Father God. But we come anyway and we give it to you, Father. Lord, accept us. Accept us as filthy rags, O God, and cleanse us, Lord. Cleanse us from all our unrighteousness, O God. Lord, we depend on you, O God. We love you. We love you because you first loved us. We love you because you want us to live in eternity with you in your kingdom. We love you because you want us to live a righteous life. Righteousness is doing right in the eyes of God. And strengthen us that we can do right in your eyes, Father God. Strengthen us, Father God, that when we fail, oh God, you're going to pick us up. You're going to strengthen us and we will go again, Lord, oh God. Help us, we will not give up. We know it's a fight, oh God. And you know that we cannot do it alone, Father God. You stay the course with us, Father, and you give us that strength to keep going forward, Father God. That we won't miss the mark. That we will live with you in eternity when that time comes, Father God. That you're going to say, well done, good and faithful servant. We thank you. We praise your holy name, Lord. And all of us tonight in one accord come to before you, Father God, and we bow down before you. We bow down before your throne. And we ask you, God, to touch us, Lord. Touch our hearts. That we can draw closer to you, God. We can come more and more involved in the Holy Spirit, oh God. That you will cover us wherever we go, God. You would keep us in your bosom, Lord. Lord, that we will continue to be righteous. Righteous in your sight, oh God. And when we slip, oh God, we know that you're going to pick us up. Lord, we thank you. We praise you for all that you have done, oh God. And we continue to ask for a blessing upon us, upon our family, upon loved ones, upon our friends, oh God. That all of them would get to know and to understand and to love and want to share in your kingdom and your righteousness. Lord, we praise you. We thank you, God, for this opportunity to come again before you. And we place everything into your hands. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
That prayer of seeking first the kingdom of heaven and all its righteousness. So let me invite you all down to the altar. Bring your needs. Come and present yourself, because God is waiting to answer. He will answer humility. He will answer righteousness. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Brother Neva is coming to pray for the needs. So whatever the needs are, you tap in and you agree. Thank you, Jesus.
Father, as they come, oh Lord Jesus, Father, you know exactly what they are going through, Lord. You know exactly what they are dealing with, oh God. Father, you know exactly what's drawing them to the feet of the altar, Lord. You know exactly, Lord, what has them on their knees tonight. You know exactly, oh God, what brought them to the corner of Keith and Prince of Wales Street, oh God, on this Monday evening. Father, you know it all, oh God, and we thank you, Lord. We thank you that they are in the place, oh God, where battles are fought and won. We thank you, oh Lord, that whatever the battle they might be facing, oh God, Whatever that is, Lord Jesus, that they're facing, that have them on their knees, oh God, that they're going to get the victory, oh God. Because we serve you, a God that is more than able. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the only creator. Oh Lord Jesus, everything else was created beings. Even Lucifer, Lord Jesus, is a creative being. He has no power over us because the same power that raised Christ from the dead, it lives in us. Oh Lord Jesus, so we cry out to you. Lord Jesus, we cry out to you today, Lord, and we ask you. So Lord, as I lead your people, Lord, those at the altar say, Lord, help my family. Lord, save my family. Say, Lord, help my finances. Say, Lord, make a job for me. Lord, you hear their cry, oh God. Father God, as I come to you this evening, oh God, Father, I pray, Lord Jesus, that you would make a way, Lord. Father, Lord, first of all, in our families, oh God. Father, Lord, we live in a house and many of us, oh Lord, are afraid to go home, oh God. Many of us don't want to go home, oh God. There's no love, there's no peace, there's no joy, oh God. It once was there, Lord, but it's no longer there, Lord. Father, Lord, we will stay late at work, oh Lord. We will find every excuse there is in the book to not go home, oh Lord. We will stop at the bars, oh God, and stay at the bars just to pass time, oh Lord, because there is no peace in the house, oh Lord. Brother is fighting brother. Mother and fathers can't seem to get along. Oh Lord Jesus, father, mother-in-laws and daughter-in-laws, oh God, they want to have each other next, oh Lord. But Father, Lord, we pray right now, oh Lord Jesus, for families, oh Lord, because Lord, you created families. Lord, families is something that's very close to you. Lord, you designed it, oh Lord. And Father God, I pray, Lord Jesus, that Lord, the thorns and the enemies that come, Lord Jesus, in our life, oh Lord, to create havoc, Father, I speak right now your peace, oh Lord. I speak, oh Lord, for your family, oh Lord, that it will have your joy, it will have your love, Lord Jesus. The very same ones, oh Lord, that we will die for, oh Lord, are the very ones that, Lord, serious, Lord, they are fighting us down. Father, I pray for peace, Lord. Nothing hurts, oh God, as the ones that hurt us, oh God, is our loved ones, oh God. Our loved ones hurt us the most, oh Lord. And Lord Jesus, the truth be told, oh Lord, we don't want to hurt each other, but Lord, somehow, oh Lord, we just can't seem to get the words right, oh Lord. Wisdom isn't in our words, oh Lord. We speak words that cut, oh Lord. We don't speak words that heal. We don't speak words that edify. Oh Lord Jesus, help us, oh Lord. Oh Lord, you give us that wisdom, oh God, to speak the right words, to speak love, to speak kindness, oh Lord Jesus. Oh God, to speak, oh God, to our families, oh God. Father, you said in Proverbs 8:11, it says, for wisdom is better than rubies, and all the things that may be desired are not to be compared to it. So, Father, give us the wisdom. Father, give us the wisdom. Lord, when we get your wisdom, Lord, we will know how to deal with every situation that we will face. We will know to deal with every conflict that arises in our family. We will know, Lord Jesus, that we have your wisdom. Sometimes, Lord Jesus, we might be right, but Lord, you might be saying to us to be quiet. Sometimes, oh Lord Jesus, even though we might be hurt, you might be saying, apologize. Even though we might be wronged, you might be saying, humble yourself. Lord Jesus, you give us your wisdom. Your wisdom is not our wisdom. We cannot fathom your wisdom. So we seek your wisdom, oh God, to how to deal with our families and our family conflicts. Father, I pray right now for every unsaved member in our family. Lord, you hear our cry. Oh Lord Jesus, we don't want them to die and go to hell, oh God. Oh Lord, spend an eternity in hell. Father, I pray right now that you will, Lord, save them, oh Lord. You, Lord, through us, oh Lord, let them see you, Lord. Through us, oh Lord, let them see you. Lord, they might be backslidden, Lord. They might turn away, oh Lord. Some of them might even be atheists, oh Lord, due to deep hate and pain, oh God, that create hate, oh Lord Jesus. Lord, you, oh God, plow up the heart, oh Lord. plow up that fallow ground, oh God, in their heart, oh Lord, so that they might receive you, Lord Jesus. Holy Spirit, you draw them. You give us a word, Lord, in season, Lord, that we might speak. Something we might say, something we might do, Lord Jesus. Lord, give us ears to hear, Lord, exactly how you would speak, how we are to speak with them. Lord Jesus, sometimes it isn't just speaking Jesus. Sometimes it's just through act of kindness and act of love, oh Lord, that they will see you, oh God. Father God, I pray for our finances, oh God. Father, in Proverbs 8, it says, oh God, in 18, oh God, it's verse 18, it says, riches and honor are with me. Yeah, durable riches and righteousness. In 19, my fruit is better than gold, yeah, than fine gold, and my revenue than choice silver. And in 21, it says, hallelujah, that I may cause those that love me to inherit substance, and I will fill their treasures. Father, I pray, Lord Jesus, for those that love you, O God, to inherit substance and fill them with treasures, O God. Father, we are the ones that love you. Those that are here at the altar are the ones that love you. Father, you created substance, O Lord. You caused them to inherit substance, O Lord. You paid for it all on the cross, O Lord. Father God, give us the wisdom, O God, to see things, O Lord, in your way, Lord Jesus. Give us that wisdom, O God, to have that innovative idea and innovation, O Lord, that comes only from you, O God. And Father, we pray, Lord, that, Lord, you will give us that idea, Lord. You will show us where to go, Lord. And Lord, you will create a way, Lord, for us, oh God, because we are the ones that love you. Father, we thank you, Lord, that you will create treasures, oh Lord. Father God, we will have no lack. Father, each and everyone here, Lord, who are working, Lord Jesus, and they can't, as soon as they work, oh Lord, the money is just going in bills, oh God. They feel like they're just working to pay bills, oh God. Father, you, Lord Jesus, give us substance, oh Lord. You give us that inheritance, oh Lord, that comes from you. Oh God, give us the wisdom, Lord, and how to acquire wealth, oh God. Because we need that wisdom, Lord. Not just how to acquire it, but how to keep it, oh Lord. So we thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Your eyes are beholding, Lord Jesus, from one end to the next, Lord. Your people are kneeling, Father. They are before you, O God. They are in your presence, Father. And Lord, sometimes our greatest need may not be a financial breakthrough. Father God, we may have all that we have, but Father God, Lord Jesus, we know that sickness is not of you, but it is of the enemy this evening, Father. Lord Jesus, it is not your will that there be any sickly amongst us, O God. And Lord Jesus, sometimes, Father, we your people, Lord Jesus, your word says we perish for a lack of knowledge, Lord God. And Lord Jesus, sometimes we embrace things that we ought not to embrace, Lord. Father God, sometimes, oh God, we say that whatever we are suffering with within our bodies, Lord, it is hereditary, Jesus. Father God, we often say that it is, you know, our parents, our grandparents, Lord. But this evening, oh God, it is a curse, Lord Jesus. And Father God, every hereditary sickness this evening, God, Father God, we bind it. Father God, we curse it. Father God, we burn it out in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, we say that that sickness, oh God, will no longer, oh Father, plague our families this evening, Jesus. Father God, diabetes and high blood pressure, Lord, low blood pressure, Father, Lord Jesus, It is not of you this evening, Father. And Father God, these hereditary, Father God, diseases, Father God, we rebuke it and we send it back from whence it came, O God. We are the righteous, Lord, and I know that you have heard that prayer, the prayers of repentance, God. Your people, O God, before they brought their needs, O God, to the altar, God, they sought, God, first the kingdom of heaven and its righteousness. They sought the kingdom things, O God. So this evening, O Father, I pray that you will hear that prayer, O God, for healing this evening, Father. Father God, we begin with the mind, God. Father God, sometimes in families we see, oh Father God, this madness, this mental illness, oh God, that go, oh God, from one to the next, from generation to generation. But Lord God, I pray, oh God, this evening, we pray for soundness of mind, oh Father God. We rebuke the enemy, oh Father God. We as the righteous, oh God, we decree and we declare that no madness, Lord, oh God, no mental illness will plague our families this evening, oh God. For you, oh God, have not given us, Lord Jesus, oh God, that, oh Father God, which the enemy has placed, oh God. But God, you have given us a spirit of soundness of mind this evening. So Father God, I pray that your people will touch their heads and decree and declare soundness of mind over themselves, soundness of mind over their children, their spouses, their families, Lord. Let there be soundness of mind this evening, God. Lord Jesus, this evening, oh Lord God, Father God, I pray this evening, oh God, for your people, oh God. Lord Jesus, there has been sicknesses and diseases that have been plaguing and troubling your people, oh God. Lord God, some of us, Lord, we have been dealing with things, oh God, for months, some of it for years, God, and there are unexplainable things, Lord Jesus. There is no real reason, oh God, and the doctors have told us, Lord Jesus, Father God, that we will have to take medication, oh God, until we close our eyes. But God, this evening, we come trusting you this evening, oh God. We come presenting ourselves, oh God, because you said, oh God, in your word that our bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit this evening. And God, if the temple be sick, oh God, Lord Jesus, how are we going to be used, God? How are we going to work for you, God? So this evening, oh God, I pray, oh God, this evening that you will touch, Lord Jesus. Touch your people. Send forth your ministering angels in the midst of the altar this evening, Lord. May the angels, the ministering angels, touch this evening, oh God. May they touch your people in their bodies, in their minds, oh God, this evening. Lord Jesus, I pray this evening, I pray that the faith of your people will arise this evening, oh Lord. Father God, some of us need healing in our faith this evening, Jesus. Oh God, and I pray, oh God, because you also respond to faith this evening, oh God. If we lack faith, oh God, and we pray, oh God, without faith, believing, oh God, our prayers will return to us void, God. So help us, oh God, to understand this evening that our prayer needs to be coupled with faith, oh God, mixed with faith this evening, oh God, so that we can walk, oh God, in the Lord Jesus, in our healing this evening, Father. Lord Jesus, I pray this evening that your people will understand, Lord Jesus, that they will get that wisdom from your word, oh God, and they will read your word, and they will come to know the God who hears and the God who heals. You are the Jehovah Rapha, oh God, this evening, and I pray, oh God, Jehovah Rapha, that you will walk in the midst and heal your people this evening, Father. Lord Jesus, whatever your people trust in you for, Lord, there are so many things, God, and who can know this body better than you, Lord Jesus. So I pray, oh God, that you will touch this evening, Father. Father God, touch the hearts, Lord, where there is heart trouble, Lord. Lord Jesus, you fix that heart this evening. Maybe there is someone on the airwaves, Lord, looking in, Lord. And the doctors have said that the heart is weak, Lord. I pray that you will strengthen that heart, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, maybe the kidneys may be failing this evening, Lord. I pray that you will touch the kidneys, Lord, and cause it to function to full capacity this evening, Father. Oh God, Jesus, someone may be trusting you, Lord. They require a blood transfusion this evening, God. I pray that you, oh God, will infuse that, Lord Jesus, with the blood of Jesus. Cause healing to come to your people, oh Lord, as they will trust you, Lord. As they will trust you, Father, as their faith, oh God, would rise and be in operation this evening. I pray that every person that has a trouble, a health trouble, or an issue this evening, God, will not walk out here the way they came in, God, but that they will walk out, oh Lord, like when you heal the lepers, Lord, and when you heal the blind, oh God. Praising you, Lord Jesus, because God, we must understand, Lord, the praise, the worship this evening, Father. Our God, and I pray this evening, God, that the testimonies will be great, Jesus, because God, they can come to the God of their healing this evening. They have come to the God who is the supplier of all their needs this evening. Lord, because they have turned this evening, Jesus, I know that you are the reader of minds and the searcher of the hearts this evening, Father. So, Father God, I thank you, Lord, for the healing. Healing is the children's bread, Jesus. I pray that they will eat this evening, Lord. I pray, oh God, because it is a promise in your word to your children. I pray, oh God, that as they will eat, healing will come to their body, Father. In Jesus, I thank you for healing, Jesus. Father God, we give you praise. Father God, we give you thanks, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus this evening, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Let me invite you to stand just for a few more minutes before we leave. Let me just help you to understand what you're just singing. Because sometimes we are guilty of singing and saying things that we really don't understand. When you have the understanding of what you're singing, you would know how to receive. The God we serve is the great and almighty God. He is so great and he's so big that no one name could truly describe who he is. And what we are really seeing here, we are seeing some of the names that represents the character of the God that you serve. So when you say these words, it's not there like they are foreign words and you just sing the words without any meaning. I want you to get some understanding in what you're singing. The chorus says, Yahweh. Yahweh is the I am. Remember in the beginning of times, when Moses had to go to Pharaoh, he said, who shall I tell them? Send me. say, tell him, the I am that I am. In the Gospels, it was manifested in the personality of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He says, I am the bread of life. I am the living water. I am the light of the world. I am the resurrection and the life. He is the I am that I am. He's Yahweh. He is Rapha. Rapha means healer, the one who heals. And we just prayed about healing. We are really calling on Jairus and Rapha to heal us this evening. Because he operates in different kinds of dimension. It's where you want him, it's where he's going to come. He's not going to come in your life where you have not invited him. You have to invite him. So if you want a healing, you invite him. God, you are Rapha. You are the God that heals every sickness. And when we say every sickness, we mean every sickness. There is nothing that he cannot heal. You think of the worst disease. Rapha could heal. He's Elohim. Elohim means the mighty God. He is mighty. He can do more than we could ask or even think. He's so mighty that, listen, with a command from his lips, he could create and creative power. Like, let there be light. That is the God you serve. And that is one of the qualities that he wants you to manifest, that when you opened your mouth to speak, life, power, call the things that are not as though they were. He's Elohim. He's Shaddai. The Almighty. That is who he is. He's Almighty. There is nothing that this God cannot do. He's Almighty. He's Jireh. The God who will supply your every single need. The same God that was there watching over Abraham. When Abraham carried his only son to sacrifice him. When God held back his hand, the Bible says, God provided for him a lamb. And he called that place the place where God would have provided. I don't know what you're going through tonight. Maybe you have a need. But you need to call on Jireh, the God that is able to provide. Number six. So he's Yahweh the I Am. He's Rapha the healer. Eloi, the mighty God. El Shaddai, the almighty. Jireh, the provider. Adonai, the Lord, the all-powerful one. So tonight, for the next few minutes, I just want you to call. That one area in your life tonight. That one area. Don't confuse yourself. That one area. If the most important thing to you right now is a healing, who are you going to call? Who are you going to call? I'm now teaching you. Who are you going to call? We're going to call upon Rapha. We're going to call upon the God that is able to heal. And let me tell you something. No doubting. No doubting. He says, when you pray, believe that whatever you ask in his name, he's going to bring it to pass. No doubt. No doubt, pray. Pray. We have suffered too long. We have been through depression for too long. We have been sick on medication for too long. This is your moment. Stand in faith. Sing it in words. Now you know what you're singing. You take what is for you tonight. If your need is a financial miracle, calling Jireh. The God is going to provide whatever it is. Provide a job, provide a spouse, provide a house, provide. Listen, his name, he's able. He can do abundantly above all that we could ask or even think. So we're going to do it again. Do it now with the understanding. And you take time now to call upon the Lord our God. Hallelujah. Yahweh.
Yahweh.
He's the I Am.
Rapha.
The mighty healer.
Elohim.
The mighty creator.
Shaddai.
He's the almighty God.
Jireh.
The one who is going to provide your every need. Yes, he's Lord, the most powerful one. Hallelujah. Let's sing it and worship again tonight. It's beautiful. Do it one more time before we pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah. This is our prayer tonight, that the mighty God of heaven is going to manifest himself, Lord, to your people tonight, to your people tonight, just like you did it to Moses, just like you manifest yourself to Jacob, just like you manifest yourself to Apostle Paul on the Damascus Road. Lord, you could manifest yourself to your people standing in these altars tonight. My God, they are desirous of your mighty power tonight. They are desirous of your healing presence. They are desirous that of you supplying their every need. They are desirous to see the power of God in their lives. My God, some of them need to move mountains tonight. Some of them, Lord, are caught in their Red Sea tonight. Some of them are caught, my God, between a rock and a hard place. But my God, you are Adonai. You are the Lord God Almighty. You are Elohim. You are the mighty creator tonight. You could create something out of nothing. You can do the impossible. We pray tonight that you're going to release power tonight. Release power tonight upon your people, oh God. Breakthrough in their lives. Show them your power, Lord. Show them your power in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, as they cry out, Lord, to you, whatever they are crying out for tonight, manifest, 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 Lord. Maybe a deliverance tonight. Maybe a deliverance from some unclean spirit. Maybe a deliverance from a habit that needs to be broken tonight. Release your power. Set free from every bondage and every darkness and every spirit of wickedness. Loose tonight in this place. Heal all kinds of sickness. Heal the cancer tonight. You are God and you are more than able. My God, no cancer could have stand before your presence. We speak to cancers tonight. We speak to infirmities tonight. Spirit of infirmities, I command you in the name of Jesus. Dry up out of the bodies of God's children. Dry out of their head. Dry out of their organs. Dry out of their limbs. Dry out of the wombs of the woman. Dry out of the prostate. Dry out of the stomach. Dry out, Lord God, out of the joints and the bones. In the name of Jesus, we declare the healing power of Jesus to be released into the lives of the people, my God. The things that the doctors are struggling with tonight, heal it now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Heal it now in the name of Jesus. Take away every kind of trouble. Take away every kind of pain. take away every form of sickness in the name of Jesus. Bring deliverance. Bring deliverance. Provide tonight. Provide the needs of the people. Whatever they need this evening, you are more than able to do it, Lord. You are the great I am, Lord. You are God. You can do anything. So, Lord, show your power. Provide, Lord. Open up the doors for them. Grant the favor for them. My God, release the answers to their prayers. Give them their miracle. Give them the favor. Give them the release of your power in their lives. Bring the change and the transformation, we pray, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Go ahead and give him some thanks. Give him some praise. There is nothing he cannot do. He could touch your mind. He could touch your body. He could touch your soul. He could touch your loved one at home in that bed. If he could touch the centurion's servant, he could touch your loved one right now. Go ahead and pray for that sick loved one. Go ahead and pray who needs a deliverance or a breakthrough right now. Go ahead and lift your voice. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Lord, they will not do drugs again. Lord, they're going to be delivered in the mighty name of Jesus. Go ahead and speak the word. Speak the word like Elohim, the creative God. Speak the word. Lord, we declare it tonight. Go ahead and declare it with power. Declare it with confidence. Declare it with faith that our God is able to do more than we can ask or even think. Pray that God is going to touch your husband tonight. Deliver him from the alcohol. Deliver him from that kind of abusiveness that he brings into the house. Nobody in the house is comfortable when he is in the house. Pray against that spirit. Break it now in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, pray for your children. Call them my name right now, wherever they are. In the drug den, call them. Call them out of the drugs. Call them out of the pornography. Call them from the bad company. Speak the word into their lives. The word of God says we can declare it. Speak the things that are not as though they were in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Pray for your children. Those that are sick in the hospital, pray for them. Those that are sick at home, pray for them. You call upon the Lord for them. In the name of Jesus. Those that have stroke and are in bed, speak the word now that God is going to heal them and lift them up out of their bed of affliction. Speak to those, my God, who are suffering with all kinds of impediments, all kinds of lameness, all kinds of blindness. Speak to those that are unable to speak well, that the Spirit of God is going to loose them. Loose their tongues tonight. Loose their mouths tonight, that they will speak. That they will speak and glorify the Father in the name of the Lord Jesus. Loose those feeble legs. Loose those weak knees. My God, we call strength to come right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, those that are home in our homes and they are not troubled by devils and demons, those that are oppressed, those that are oppressed by the devil, tonight in the name of Jesus, go ahead, speak over their lives. Speak the word. We bind every kind of demon possession tonight. Devil, in the name of Jesus, you hear us. We send our word. We send our word. We send our word. We speak deliverance. Every devil, every demon, every unclean spirit, in the name of Jesus, we destroy your work. We break your power. We loose you. We loose your stronghold from the minds of our loved ones and our family members. My God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray, let the power of God be released into our homes. Release into our homes. My God, we send peace. Go ahead and send the peace of God. Go ahead. You're going to walk home into your house tonight in peace. Nobody's going to say a word to you tonight. Nobody's going to trouble you tonight. We declare peace against the works of the enemy. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we declare your peace. Nothing broken, nothing missing. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Our Father, we give you praise. Somebody give him praise. Somebody worship him. Oh, go ahead and bless him. Somebody open your mouth and say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's right. Go ahead. Give him a high praise this evening. Give him a high praise. Oh, somebody could clap their hands. Somebody could shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Tonight is a night of victory. Tonight is a night of deliverance. Tonight is a night of breakthrough. Our homes are free. Our lives are free. Our loved ones are free in the name of the Lord Jesus. And Lord, your word declares that who the Son of God set free is free indeed. It's free indeed. It's free indeed. It's free indeed. It's free indeed. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, let's sing Yahweh. Hallelujah. Sharanababa Sikorobobo. Shinidime Sikariyananababa. Yes, yes.
Reminding you that the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Amen. So we give him one note of praise. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for a wonderful time in your presence, Lord. We will not fail to give you all the honor and all the praise. Lord, we know you will manifest yourself. Lord, we look forward to the many testimonies, God, coming out from your people, Lord. And as they would go out into this wicked world, Lord, I pray that you will shield them. You will continue to keep them in your right hand. Lord, help them to remember that their name is in your right hand, and you will continue to uphold them from the evil one. So, Father, we give you all the praise and all the glory and all the